Welcome to another episode of Duck's Electronic Repair Bench.
Evening, YouTube. Here with you on this Sunday evening to bring you this. I found the case for the transmitter, and I'm going to put that together and put the transmitter in it. And I probably won't post this by itself, probably post it with the test of the transmitter tomorrow when I do that. I've got to come up with some equipment here to do the testing, mainly something to play music through the transmitter, or an MP3 player or something like that, and then a radio to receive it on. And I have a couple, three radios, obviously, but trying to do this with the least possible clutter on my bench so I can get it all in camera or whatever. So anyway, let's go ahead and put this together and see what we got. All right, what we have here is the, not finished, but basically finished, case. Let me turn around here and show you the front of it. So that's the front of it. Here's the back of it. So that's pretty much how that looks. There's the bottom of it. Got the feet on it. All the screws are in. So it's not bad. Not bad at all. The switch works just fine. I'm gonna leave the top off. Off right there. It secures with these holes here. There's two screws left to do that. Like I said, this is that will be the last thing I do, is put that on there after I get it all adjusted and everything. There's no sense in trying to. I don't know if I can get. You know, see here. There's these two tremors here. This one in here and this one here. Have to be gotten to, and the jumpers have to be set, so there's no sense in putting that top on yet until I get it checked out. So at least it'll be within its little chassis here, so that should be well enough to provide the whatever I need for that. So that's gonna do that, and I think it turned out rather well. I do believe I'm happy with it. If it will just work, I will be even happier. So, you guys stay tuned for the upcoming demo, test, alignment, whatever you want to call it. And that'll happen tomorrow. It's going on 10 if it's not after 10. Yeah, it's 20 after 10 now. On a Sunday evening, so I will be going to bed shortly. And you guys have a pleasant evening, and we'll see you tomorrow. Ah, morning YouTube, back with you as promised. I I took that, left that vinegar sit on that, on those feet overnight to kind of help them situate like they're supposed to be. I just put that top on for temporary until the time to get the adjustments made. I got to get that back in order, get the ends made for that, and so I've got the soldering iron heating up. First order of business here, besides doing this, getting that ready, is to get a radio ready to go. What I'm going to do is, one of my GE portables, that one works. But I'm going to use the other one because it needs to be done anyway. I've been promising the girls I'd get it done so they could use it in the bathroom, things like that, when they take a shower, so they can listen to the radio, things like that. That is going to involve me taking getting the AC adapter hooked back up to it, and I've got the plug-in for it. I think it's the same plug-in that this takes. power adapter thing. So we're going to check that out. And anywho, so I want to get that done, and so I'm going to cut off this and get back to it.
First traffic and weather.
All right, we have, you can see there, I found the adapter for the GE here, and I have it hooked up on the, right there. It is working. That's the AM there.
To make the repairs, the businesses would also be able to expand and hire.
That's a local station right there, 1390.
General Jeff Sessions will testify.
So AM's working pretty good on this radio. I did the alignment on it, and haven't done the FM yet. I did do the AM, and it seems to work pretty good.
To hear the truth directly.
So
you're listening to USA. Some of the hottest deals happening at Lowe's for your garden.
So that works good. Now we have a AM radio. The next thing I have to do is to fix this power supply. Although I did find a, I don't know where it went. Oh, there it is. Now this purports, I haven't got it in macro mode, but let me put it in macro mode. You can see it's a little better. Maybe. Outvolt 12 volts, 2 amps. So, output I should say. And the center is positive. So, I'm thinking maybe this one will work to power that. Not that, but the... where's that? Oh, there it is. Yeah, so it should work to power that. It does fit in the AC adapter plug for that. So I may give that a shot if it, this may be one of those, I'm thinking it is, one of those for a hard drive or something like that, and there may not be a lot of filtering in it. And it also may be a switching power supply. If it's switching, I won't be able to use it because there's just too much noise in a switching power supply to power a circuit, like a transmitter or a receiver, actually. So, all right, gonna get back to work and get this powered up. Or get this working, I should say. And once that's done, we can at least get a good filtered power supply for the transmitter itself. So next thing we'll do is, after that, is to get a source for my audio. Thinking about using the phone and trying to find a 1000 hertz tone for it so I can just play that continuously. And use that for my alignment at least. Obviously the audio won't, when I use it for audio, that won't be it. But for alignment, it would be good, I think. So, all right, let me get on that and get back to you a little bit.
And
all right, what we have here is the power supply hooked up to the
and now for something deliciously different from Wendy's double stack heater. Still an option in the 4 for 4.
Now it's saying 1.16, the my meter says 1.2. Let's take it up a little bit.
Wouldn't like that deal.
4.7, and this is 4.72. That's not bad. That's workable. I can live with that. And just make sure the I want to make sure these are working good, and they are. They are hooked up properly. So I do have a power source now for the adapter there. I think it goes up to 12 volts, no problem. Yeah, there's 12. There's 12 volts right there. So it will work fine for that. And like I say, in case that one is too noisy. So let's get off of here and get on to the next step, which is,
okay ladies, you've got projects you want,
not really sure,
it's not getting done for whatever,
probably
reason.
Just
so
finding what do you call it for that, and
cabinetry.
Oh yeah, what the next step is, the phone, getting the phone set up to be the source, the audio source for the transmitter. So let's get that done and we'll be right back. what it's doing. I have it hooked up to my little recorder. That's the only thing I could find that would work very good. It's pretty darn close. I'm getting a lot of hum and buzz. So I think it has something to do with the orientation of this. Because if I move that closer or further away, it has something to do with it. So, it does work. I haven't adjusted anything as far as that's concerned. What I did was just basically set it up for the range of frequencies that I wanted to be in, which is the upper frequencies. And basically I just turned it on and tried to find that signal, which I did pretty easily. So it does work. Like I said, it just part of that buzz or hum, I think, is from the power supply. The power supply of the radio. Maybe, I don't know. Let me turn this off and see. No, not the radio. Definitely from here. So, anyway, it does work. That's good. Let's see what turning this up does, if anything. That's about optimum right there. So anyway, it does work, and happy about that. I think it's just going to take some tuning to get it working properly. The power supply doesn't keep up with it very well. If I put it on 12 volts, it won't go up to... It'll go up to 12 volts if it's off, and then as soon as I turn it on, it drops down to this range. 7 point whatever. But I can go up a little higher than that, I think. Yeah, I think I'm getting some buzz from that ROM, I should say. So... I try hooking it up to the DC power supply of the Variac and see if it works any better off of that. And anyway, it does work. So that was the main thing I was after, to find out if it worked. Anywho, let's go ahead and shut this down. Alright, one thing I wanted to add. This is the same thing going with the wall wart. And I do hear a lot of hum, but I'm going to show you what I found out. Let me play this tone real quick. Now, that's not touching anything, but if I touch this antenna, it clears up just fine. Or vice versa, if I touch over here, it clears up a little bit. Seems to be a grounding problem. It's best when I touch the antenna like that. So, anyway, I did get the phone working, by the way. I took the cover off because it wasn't letting the plug fall in or go in far enough. So, I have music on there as well, if I can find it. Same one. It's a little bit more garbled off of the phone. I think the maybe overpowering it a bit compared to the little voice recorder. It does work though. As long as I hold this wire, it seems to be fairly quiet. I just need to find out why the what the problem is with that. Maybe you know, run a ground over to something. Try that anyway and see if that works. So. Alright, we're going to get off here now for sure this time and go back to the other camera and we'll end this up. Alright, as I just demonstrated, it does work. It's not perfect, obviously. For one thing, everything's all close together here, and I don't know, it's not supposed to be the way it's working. It should work.
I need a good power supply for the transmitter. Anywho, that's one of the things I need to come up with, a good power supply. The other thing is to tune it in. I haven't tuned anything. All I've done is put the little pins, shorting pins over the thing to get the right range, and that's all I've done. So there are several things you can do to tune it into a different station, maybe, or something like that. But I figured this way it was going to be whatever station it came out to be, and it works. But like I said, there's a hum in it, and I think that was one of the complaints of somebody else I listened to a review on YouTube. There was a hum in it. So I think it has a lot to do with where this is put at, because I moved it away from the radio and the hum went down substantially. So just going to take some more playing around with it and get it to work. also, I need a better source, audio source. I guess I could have brought my computer in here. I don't have anything that goes from stereo out on the computer and the like MP3 players, things like that, to a mono source. I need to set something like that up too, get that working. And then once I do that and I have a constant source, I can play around with the adjustments on this. I think it'll be a much better unit to mess with. But what I want to do is move the radio over back there somewhere, and so I can go ahead and adjust it here and maybe hear what it sounds like away from the radio. I think that would be a better situation. So that's about going to do it for this video. If it's too long, I apologize, Marty. If it's too short, I apologize for anybody that don't like them short. It's kind of hard to keep up with everybody. But anyway, you guys have a great day. Thanks so much for watching. We will see you.